The very first thing to consider before doing the baking process is that you have to do your UV maps first. Because the details that you will put, the creases, the sculpting, all of that will be based on how you do your UV maps, on how you arrange them. That's why we have prepared the UV layout first before adding the details. Basically, baking allows us to have high poly-like meshes even though in reality, we only have a low poly one. So even though there is a limitation on the poly count, we can still do detailed items with the help of baking. Okay? Now, in order for us to create the details, we have to make a copy of our object that we want to put extra details on. Say for example, this sweatshirt right here. Let's create a duplicate. Press Shift and D. Then rename the duplicated one to something that will help you distinguish high poly and low poly. So personally, I will just add HP for the high poly at the end of the name. Next, I will just hide the original top and let me focus on this supposed to be high poly. To make our object high poly, well selected, go here in the modifier properties and add a subdivision surface. I usually increase the level to 3, but you can go higher if you want. But just a fair warning, if you increase it at a very high level, your computer might hang and crash if your computer specs cannot handle it because the more polygons we have in our scene, the heavier our file gets. So please save your progress so you won't lose it halfway, okay? Then I'll just apply the subdivision surface. If you check it to edit mode, you can now see that the components are very dense as compared to the original one. Let's now add creases to our top. Go to sculpt mode and choose a brush that is suitable for creases. My sculpting usually revolves around the draw sharp, and crease brush. You may want to determine the purpose of other brushes on your own for us to save time here. You may also adjust the size of your brush according to the size of the creases that you want to put. Also, you can turn this X button beside this butterfly icon so that the sculpting that you create on one side will be sculpted to the other side. So now, watch me carefully as I do the details. If you want to soften the edges of your sculpting, you can press Shift while brushing over the sculpt. After you have sculpted the details, we're now good to go in baking. Go back to object mode, show the low poly version, click the high poly first on the outliner, then press shift and select the low poly. Please take note of the sequence of selecting your objects because this is important. After selecting, go here in the shading tab. Zoom in to your object. In the space below, press Shift and A, then search Normal Map. You will now have the Normal Map node here. In some cases, there is already a Normal Map node added here, especially if you made your item from the mask. So if you have one already, no need to add more. Press Shift A again, then search Image Texture. Click New. Add a name for your normal map. And change the size to 512 by 512. Click OK. Change the color space sRGB to non-color. Then, connect these dots here, color to color, normal to normal. There! After that, go here in the render properties which have the camera icon here. Change the render engine, EV, to cycles. Scroll down until you find the bake tab. Change the bake type combined to normal. Put a check in the selected to active. This is why I ask you to select the high poly first so that the details of the high poly will be embedded in the low poly one. High to low. Clear? Clear. Then, expand the selected to active subcategory and increase the value of extrusion. This will cover the space between your low poly and high poly so that the bumps from your sculpting will be covered well. For those ZEPETO 3D creators who have experienced baking already and there are yellow patches in their normal maps, try increasing the value of extrusion here. If you are too lazy to correct the color in Ibis Paint or other photo editing apps, because the normal map here should be blue and some shade of pink and green. Now on the extrusion, I usually put 65 on mine, but it's up to you to play with the values here that will fit you. Next, here on the output subcategory, change the value of margin to 0. Now that everything is done, make sure that the image texture here is active by clicking it, then press the bake button. Wait for the baking to finish. The normal map has now appeared. However, as you notice, the sculpting looks like it's inverted. The sculpting should have bumps and not be submerged. So to fix that, go here in the three dashed lines, image, invert, invert green channel. Now, your sculpting should appear as it should. After that, we can now export your normal map by going here in the three dashed lines, again, image, save as. Then, save it to somewhere you will remember, then click save as image. For those who have experience using ZEPETO Unity, the normal map will be placed in the second box of width standard. To check it here in Blender, go back to the layout tab, hide the high poly, and choose the material preview button. That's it for this video. I hope you learned something new for today. See you in the next one. Bye!